Hello students, welcome to Smart Engineering Tutorials. So, in continuation to angle modulation, the two common methods of angle modulation are frequency modulation and phase modulation. First of all, we'll see phase modulation or PM. Phase modulation is that form of angle modulation in which the angle theta IT is varied linearly in accordance to the message signal MT as theta IT is equals to 2 pi FCT plus KP MT. So here if we see that the angle which has been changed, how it has been changed, like theta IT is equal, this is an angle and it is equal to the sum of two angles. You can see like this. And 2 pi FCT is the angle of unmodulated carrier. So, the angle of unmodulated carrier will be varied directly in phase modulation. So, how it is being changed? Like 2 pi FCT plus KP into MT, where MT is considered as the message signal and is treated as a voltage waveform. And this KP is the phase sensitivity of modulator in radians per volt. So we have seen the how the angle is varied in phase modulation according to the message signal. This is the angle of unmodulated carrier. It is varied according to the message signal. And initially we saw of unmodulated carrier, like we have said that theta, let's say theta angle of unmodulated carrier is equals to 2 pi FCT plus phi C, and this was the angle of the carrier at T equals to 0, and we have considered or we have assumed it to be 0 to make things simple. This phi C will not be seen in any picture, in any expression, since we have assumed it to be 0. So the equation of angle of the in terms of phase modulation, the angle which we get is this in term, and it is the unmodulated carrier's angle is varying according to the message signal. So if we want to write the equation of phase modulated signal ST, it can be written as ST is equals to AC, the amplitude is constant of the carrier, so AC cos theta IT, and theta IT is the angle of the phase modulated wave, and it is obtained by 2 pi FCT plus KP into MT. So this is the equation of PM wave. Now we will move towards the another wave, that is the another kind of modulation, which is the frequency modulation. So if we define it, frequency modulation, it is that form of angle modulation in which the instantaneous frequency FI suffix IT is varied linearly with the message signal MT. So in phase modulation, the angle theta is varied directly according to the message, and here in frequency, since the angle part, the angle as a whole, if we break it, it also has a frequency term inside it. So it is a part of angle modulation. Frequency modulation is a part of angle modulation because if we change frequency, it will ultimately result in change in angle. That's why it is also called a type of angle modulation. But actually, here the frequency is being changed, and in phase modulation, the angle is changed directly. Here, directly frequency will change, and which will lead to change in angle. This is the main basic difference between FM and PM in technique point of view. So frequency modulation, here the instantaneous frequency FIT is varied linearly with the message signal MT, for which we have written the equation how this frequency is varying. So instantaneous frequency, how it varies, of we have the module the carrier, it's the unmodulated carrier's frequency is FC, and how this frequency of unmodulated carrier is varying according to the message signal, because now the message is being sent in its frequency. So how this frequency is varying? So the relation is FC plus KF into MT. This MT is message signal, which is treated as a voltage waveform, and this KF is the frequency sensitivity in hertz per volt, and FC, I have already told, frequency of unmodulated carrier. Now we have talked about how the frequency of the carrier is varying according to the message signal, and we want ultimately to write the equation of the FM wave. So for writing the equation of FM wave, how can we write? We know that the changes in frequency will lead to changes in angle. So first of all, these changes in frequency, from this we have to find the angle. So FIT, from this we have to find theta IT. So to find theta IT from FIT, which will ultimately give us the equation, because the equation we want is AC cos theta IT. And we know FIT. From FIT we have to find theta IT to obtain this equation. So we have already seen that before, we have found the equation that FIT is equals to 1 upon 2 pi d by dt of theta IT. We have seen this already in my previous video. From there I have derived this equation that if we want to calculate theta IT, how will we calculate? Theta IT is equals to 2 pi multiplied by FIT, and since here this side it is d by dt of theta IT, so to obtain theta IT we will take integration. So theta IT can be obtained by taking integration from 0 to t of the instantaneous frequency and multiplying it by 2 pi. So then in next equation what I have written, theta IT is equals to, I put the value of FIT which we have obtained above. So 2 pi and integration of, I have taken this whole value in place of FIT. So FC dt plus 2 pi into KF is a constant, I have taken outside, integration 0 to t MT and dt. So this is theta IT. Now I have solved this, the theta IT, I have solved the above equation and obtained theta IT is equals to, this will give 2 pi FCT plus 2 pi KF and this integration of MT dt. So for simplicity, I have already seen that we have taken phi, the angle of the carrier at t equals to 0 as 0 to remove the complexity. So we have obtained this equation for the angle from instantaneous frequency. Now we can write the frequency modulated signal. Its equation can be written, ST is equals to, I have told, AC cos theta IT is the ultimate equation we want to find, and we knew FIT, from there we have calculated theta IT, and now we will get this whole equation, and the whole equation of FM wave is ST is equals to AC cos in bracket theta IT 2 pi FCT plus 2 pi KF integration 0 to t MT dt. So now this whole angle is theta IT, and now we have seen in phase modulation, we have seen that the angle is directly modified of the unmodulated carrier, like it was written like 2 pi FCT plus KP MT. Here simple message was there with KP, and here in frequency modulation the integration of MT is there. So we say that, this is again theta IT, we say that theta IT depends on MT in case of phase modulation or integration of MT in frequency modulation. This means that since the angle is depending upon message or on its integration, so this means that the regularity or the zero crossings, zero crossings means if I say this is a signal and this is the zero line, then these are the points at which the signal crosses the zero line. These are called the zero crossings. So we say that since the angle is depending upon message and its integration, so these zero crossings of PM or in FM, they no longer have a perfect regularity in their spacing. It means that these what we are drawing here like this, these are regular waves. But since these are depending their frequency, or the we are saying the angle, it is depending on mt. So now this spacing or the regularity of the oscillation, it will not be regular. These spacings will not be regular. For example, in frequency modulation, where the signal will be high, the frequencies will be very close, and where the signal will be low, it will be very far, or it will be low frequency, because the message is being sent in the frequency. So it will be, so at some places it will be high, at some places it will be low. So the space, we are saying that the regularity of the wave has been changed. And in case of FM, there will be some changes in the phase, like it will change like here it is being, we are showing the transition levels with the how the data is changing. If there is a change, it will show a phase change of pi. You have already seen in ASK, FSK, PSK how this changes are being made. I think it is more clear. Like in PSK also, the message was being sent in the phase. Similarly, here also in angle modulation, the message is being sent in the phase, which is the same as the angle. And in frequency, the frequency is being varied according to the message signal. So this is the point which we are saying, that zero crossings of PM or FM are no longer regular, means their spacings have been changed. And zero crossings, I have written here, instance of time where a wave changes from negative to positive or vice versa. So this is a very different characteristic from AM. This distinguishes FM and PM from AM, since in AM they are regular, the spacings are not changed, the amplitude is changed. So we have seen here. Now we will move further, that the envelope of FM or PM is constant, because we have already seen that in angle modulation the amplitude is constant. That means that its envelope will also be constant. Now further we are going to see that we have already made, and we have already seen these two equations, FM wave equation, ST is equals to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus 2 pi KF integration 0 to T MT DT. I have written both FM and PM wave simultaneously. So this is FM wave, in which the frequency is varying according to the integration of message signal. And PM wave, ST is equals to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus KPMT. So here the angle is varying according to the message signal MT. Now we have got both the equations. So if we see at these equations, this is a FM wave. So if we have a frequency modulator, because this is the frequency sensitivity of the modulator, so we are going to derive how to make an FM wave or a PM wave from a circuit. If we look at both these signals, they are more or less the same. The only difference, this is, these two are constants, so we are not talking about them. We are just seeing that they are means similar to each other. The only difference is that in MT, in PM, MT is used as it is, whereas in FM, the MT is taken by taking its integration, means integrated MT is taken. So this is the difference. But if we want, we can derive them from each other. FM signal can be generated from phase modulator. This is what we are trying to build a notion, that FM signal can be obtained from phase modulator. But how? How we can make? See, this FM wave, if we are going to generate an FM wave, we have a frequency modulator, frequency modulation. For that, we have frequency modulator. For phase modulation, we have a phase modulator, which we have put here. I have put in the circuit. There is a phase modulator, there is a frequency modulator. So, but what we are trying to build is that from phase modulator, how can we make FM wave, and from frequency modulator, how can we make a PM wave? So that's what we are trying to build. See, the equation of FM wave, it has MT, but its integration is used. So for FM wave, we have integrated MT. So therefore, if we have a frequency modulator, in frequency modulator, what it will do, it will multiply the message signal, not message, but its integration. Okay, the frequency modulator will multiply the signal. We have this signal carrier AC cos 2 pi FCT. It is going inside the frequency modulator. So one signal is this, and this is multiplied by the this carrier is given, and now this carrier's frequency has to be changed, and accordingly what this frequency modulator will add, its own frequency sensitivity, and what it will do, it will do the integration of the message. So we want a PM wave, we don't want an integrated message, because in PM we have MT, not its integration, but frequency modulator will do the integration. So what we will do to cancel out this integration of MT in order to obtain a PM wave, what we will do, we will, prior sending the message to frequency modulator, we initially take the modulating message, that is your MT, will send it to the differentiator. What it will do, it will differentiate it like d by dt of MT. This differentiator will do this, and when this signal will go inside the frequency modulator, what it will do, it will do its integration of the derivative of your message signal, and these two things will get cancelled, and we will get MT multiplied by the constant sensitivity of the modulator, and we have this frequency, your carrier wave, the carrier wave. Similarly, as we can see in the equation of PM wave, we have AC cos and the angle is 2 pi FCT plus KP MT. So this KP MT will now be obtained from here, and AC will now be obtained from here, KP MT, since integration and differentiation have been cancelled and MT is left, and this is the carrier which we are providing, and this whole circuit, actually we are not giving the whole description about the circuitry. This whole process will occur in this modulator part, and it ultimately will give PM wave. What the main point we were trying to highlight here is that we are, before sending the message into the frequency modulator to obtain PM, we are differentiating it prior and then sending it to the frequency modulator, so that integration and differentiation cancel out. Similarly, we have this phase modulator, and from phase modulator we are trying to generate a FM wave. But phase modulator, as in PM wave equation we have seen, it just multiplies KP into MT. So MT has to be its original form in phase modulator. It will not do its integration. So if you want to generate an FM wave, we will have to give an integrated message to this phase modulator, so that along with the carrier it generates the FM wave. So for this, what we do, we take the message signal MT and we give it to the integrator. It will integrate the message and then it will send to the phase modulator, and in this way the signal, the message signal which this phase modulator gets, is integrated MT, and along with the carrier, it will, this whole circuit will work upon the signals and give you the FM wave. So this was what this was to tell, how FM can be generated from a phase modulator, and frequency modulator, how it can generate a PM wave, phase modulated wave. This was to show this. Now moving further to frequency modulation, we want to further dig into what this frequency modulation is. So we'll further move. Now frequency modulation, we have already seen the equation just now, that this ST is equals to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus 2 pi KF integration 0 to t MT dt. So if I see here, this integration of MT makes this FM process of frequency modulation a non-linear modulation process. And moving further, we are going to consider and find some more equations with regard to frequency modulation. Let's say that we have a message signal which needs to be transmitted. Let us consider the message as a sinusoidal modulating signal MT, which is AM. M represents the message, AM cos 2 pi FMT, where FM is the frequency of the message signal. Now, we have this message. We will try to find the instantaneous frequency, and from instantaneous frequency, we will try to find the angle, and then we will develop the equation of FM wave. So, the instantaneous frequency of the resulting FM signal which we will obtain, it is what? The instantaneous frequency FIT is equals to, we have already seen the equation, FC, which is the frequency of the unmodulated carrier, and this frequency of unmodulated carrier will be changed according to the message signal. And how? It is like this: FC plus KF into MT. MT is your message signal. We'll put the value of MT here. FC plus KF into AM cos 2 pi FMT. This is the message signal we have just seen. So, here we see KF into AM. This quantity, KF into AM, I have replaced this by delta F. So, what I have written? FIT becomes FC plus delta F cos 2 pi FMT. And delta F is what? It is KF into AM. And this delta F is called the frequency deviation. What is frequency deviation? Actually, it is the deviation by that how much deviation will be there from the frequency of unmodulated carrier. How much the unmodulated carrier's frequency will deviate to accommodate the message inside it. And if we see into this equation, delta F is equal to KF into AM. And here, if KF, we know that it is a frequency sensitivity of the frequency modulator. If I remove this, then we see that delta F is directly proportional to AM. And AM is the amplitude of the message signal. So, we say that the frequency deviation or the change in frequency of the carrier is directly proportional to amplitude of the message signal, and not to the frequency of the message signal. So, where there will be higher amplitude of message, there the deviation will be larger. Means deviation will be larger means the frequency become high. And where it will be less, the deviation will be less and the frequency will become less. So, we have seen frequency deviation. And further, we are moving towards theta IT because we want to generate the equation of FM wave. So, we want to calculate theta IT, and we have just seen that theta IT is what? How can we obtain from frequency? Is that 2 pi integration 0 to t of FIT dt, that is the instantaneous frequency I have put, and theta IT is equals to 2 pi 0 to t. I have put the value of instantaneous frequency which I have obtained, FC plus delta F cos 2 pi FMT. I have put this value into dt, and if I calculate further, 0 to t integration I have done, and with FC I have got t due to integration, and delta F cos I have done the integration, I have got sin 2 pi FMT, and since this is different from t, again this whole quantity will be used, and I have written the complete integration delta F sin 2 pi FMT divided by 2 pi FM. And if I open the bracket, this 2 pi will cancel with this 2 pi, and I will get 2 pi FCT plus delta F upon this FM sin 2 pi FMT. So, this is the angle which we have obtained. Theta IT is equals to 2 pi FCT plus beta sin. Since I have a new quantity here, delta F upon FM, and this delta F upon FM, I have written it here as beta. Sin 2 pi FMT. We'll see this beta. We have got this angle from frequency FIT. We have obtained the angle theta IT. So, modulation index beta is equals to, we have just seen delta f upon fm. This delta f is the frequency deviation, this fm is the modulation frequency, and this beta is called modulation index. So the equation of angle which we have written, just 2 pi fct plus beta, which we have obtained here, this equation, that is only I am writing here, plus beta sine 2 pi fmt. So if I see this, to this equation, this is one angle and this whole is one angle, and this 2 pi fct is the angle of unmodulated carrier. And what is this? The maximum value of sine is 1. This is one angle, this is the other angle. So if we talk that about this, is that the angle of unmodulated carrier is varied according to this beta. Because if you talk about this, this maximum value is 1. So the maximum departure which can be shown is through beta. Here beta represents the phase deviation, since the angle of unmodulated carrier will vary according to the message, but in terms of beta, because it is also holding a significant value here. So beta here, it represents the phase deviation of FM signal. So if we say that phase deviation, it means how much the angle or the phase of unmodulated carrier is being varied or deviated according to the message signal. That's why it is called as phase deviation. So we can say that beta is the maximum departure of angle theta it from angle 2 pi fct of the unmodulated carrier, and beta here is in radians. So the fm signal which we can obtain, now we can write the equation, since we have got the value of angle also, and we know that the equation can be written as ST is equals to AC cos theta IT, and we have got the value for this. We'll put this value and we'll get the equation for FM wave. So ST is equals to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus beta sine 2 pi FMT. You have to learn this equation, because maybe if a numerical comes, then you'll have to compare this equation with that particular equation given in question, and you can find certain parameters. You can find the value of beta, you can find the value of FM, you can find the value of FC. So we have an important parameter, the phase deviation in this equation of FM wave, that is beta. And depending upon the value of this beta, we can define two cases of FM, that is narrow band FM and wide band FM. So for narrow band FM, beta is less than 1 radian, and for wide band FM, beta is greater than 1 radian. So depending upon these two values, you can tell whether it is a case of narrow band NBFM or wide band FM, WBFM. So for further in detail about NBFM and WBFM, we'll see further in next videos. Till then, thank you and subscribe to my channel.